You may be like a lot of other business owners who see their Facebook page reach declining. I mean, the writing's literally on the wall. Mark Zuckerberg himself said that the future is private. Well, in this video, I'm gonna teach you exactly step-by-step how to start a group for your business, break down all the group settings to create raving fans. Okay, so I'm gonna show you exactly how to set up a Facebook group. You're gonna go on the left-hand side where it says Explore, and you're gonna go to Groups. Once you click on Groups at the top left corner, there's gonna be a big blue button that says Create Group. You're gonna press that. Here, we're gonna name our group. So, SME Test. You're gonna add some people. So let's add Mitch. And then we're gonna select our privacy. We talked about that in another video up here that you can watch through step by step. So let's just do private visible. That's my favorite. And I'm also gonna press that little button that says pin to shortcuts. Then we're gonna press on create and voila, your group is created. But there's still a lot more work you need to do. So the first thing, let's just take it from top to bottom. You're gonna upload a photo. Go ahead and press that green button and fill it in with some sort of a photo that you've already created. Make that look all pretty and press save. I highly recommend that you use Canva or Easel to design that cover photo. The reason is they've already got the design templates in there so that you don't have to go and mess around with the sizing. The next thing that you're gonna do is go ahead and click more. And when you get into more, you're gonna go to edit group settings. When you go to edit group settings, we're gonna start from the top and work straight down. So we got the group name. You also might want to check out group type. It says general, or you can change it. This is where there's five different types of groups that you can do. I highly suggest either doing a general or a social learning. When you do a social learning group, you'll get to use units, and units is something that we discuss in another video that you can go check out and learn more about. So for this one, I'll go ahead and check social learning and then press save. Now, because I chose social learning, the landing tab is actually going to give me two different options. When my members come into the group, they're either going to land on the discussion, where Facebook sets the order of the posts in the tab, or units, where we can choose the order and organization of the posts in this tab. The next section is description, and you're going to want to make sure that this description tells exactly what your group is about and who it's for and who it's not for, and maybe even who it's sponsored by. This is going to help you attract and deflect the right kinds of people. The next thing is location. Depending on your business, this may or may not be good for you. Tags. Tags help people find the groups that they might be interested in joining, and you can change them at any time. The next one is apps. One example is BeLive. If you actually wanted to broadcast with BeLive TV inside of your group, you would have to go press add app and then find BeLive in here. All right, linked pages. You could create a new linked page or link your page. All you gotta do is click on it and then find which page you're gonna link here and press link. The next thing is choose color. I love this one because it's really something that helps make it stand out, especially on mobile. Customize address, I highly recommend doing this just to kind of grab it. But once your group does reach 5,000 members, you can no longer change it. And what it'll look like is facebook.com/groups/ whatever you want, provided that it's not already taken. The privacy setting. Should you ever want to change a privacy setting again, you can do it right here by changing privacy settings, and you can change it all around again. The next section is badges. And badges, they're always experimenting. Sometimes there's more, sometimes there's less. Today, it's just the founding member. The next thing here is post topics. So you can check or uncheck this box, and it basically organizes posts by adding the topics that are important to people. And you can also go through membership approval, where anyone in the group can approve members, which I don't really recommend, or only admins and the moderators. I'd go ahead and check that second one. Membership pre-approvals, if you maybe do have members that are part of another group, so maybe you already have their information, maybe they're already part of your community, and you wanna just automatically accept them without having to actually press approve. Depending on how big or small your group is, this could actually save you a lot of manpower and time. Membership requests from pages. You have the opportunity to allow other pages to become a member of your group or not. That is completely up to you. My personal opinion is not to really allow other businesses to join your group because I really love the human-to-human element inside groups. However, if you're a B2B and it makes sense for you to do that, then go for it. The next one is posting permissions. And depending on what kind of group you have, again, either anyone can post any time of the day or it has to be approved by the admin. I see that feature being used much more in like buy and sell groups where people want to approve that, you know, the poster has presented what they're selling properly and given all the information before they approve it in the group. I don't see it happening much in discussion groups. And then keyword alerts let you know when members use certain words or phrases in your group so you can react quickly if needed. This feature is amazing. Members who use keywords won't know that you're alerted, but this is a really cool way that Facebook helps you stay on top of the group. Now don't forget, no matter what settings you press at the very bottom here, we're gonna wanna press save. Now remember, any settings that you have put in here, you can come back and change at any time. So don't stress out too much, don't get anxiety, because you can always change it. Except for the vanity URL, once you have 5,000 people, you can't change it. The next logical step that you're gonna wanna do is add more people to the group. But let me warn you, people hate getting added to groups without your asking their permission first. So I would rather you post it on your page or privately invite people to join your group instead of just adding them to it. It's not often a nice way to start. Next, you're gonna wanna either show or hide the group tab on your Facebook page. So if you're really keen about getting people added to your group, I highly recommend that you show this on your Facebook page. Let me show you what I mean. We're at our main page here. Jump Consulting is my business. We're gonna go over here and click community. Once we're in community, we're gonna scroll down to groups where it says see all groups. Up here, we can link your group. You're gonna click on that and it's gonna show all the groups that you manage and you can link them to there. You might manage more groups than maybe what you want to put out there publicly, and that's okay. I do recommend only linking the higher level groups, obviously the ones that aren't a paid membership maybe, or a bonus to getting a download somewhere. So now Facebook allows you to post as your business page or your personal profile inside your group. Now, here's my personal opinion about it. There's very few times where I encourage you to post as your business page in the group. And that is only if it is a brand page, like Bella Vasta, public figure brand page, posting in the group, because it appears that it's coming from a person. I highly discourage you to use your brand that has like a logo on it, posting in the group. And my research has shown that the reach and the engagement isn't that much because people know that it's a page and it just doesn't feel warm and fuzzy. I highly recommend that more times than not, you should really be posting as your Facebook profile. Or if you're a busy brand and you're saying, Bella, I just can't personally do it, I don't want people coming at me, then that's when you definitely need a face of the community and you need a community manager or the moderators. I know that was a little confusing, so let me show you. Here we are in the Jumpstart Your Pet Business group. And just right up here where it says interacting as yourself, I can actually switch to the Jump Consulting page or to my Bella Vasta page, which is my public profile page. So now when I post something, it looks like it might be me because it's actually my Bella Vasta profile. So it's actually a picture of me. Whereas if I were to post as Jump Consulting, you see the Jump Consulting logo. In the long run, I do agree with Social Media Examiner how they love to test everything that the data shows. So if you're on the fence about it, go ahead and try to post like your business for about a week in the group and see what that does and see if you see a drop in engagement like I did. So now you have a Facebook group, now what? Well, we just so happen to have an entire playlist just for you, yay! Where we're gonna teach you how to get people in your group, grow the group, engage the group, and use a lot of different really cool features. So come along and go click on our playlist because we got a lot more in store for you.